Hey everyone, this is Mrudhula Basker and welcome back to my channel. So today we are back with another makeup look specially dedicated for you office going people and college girls. Without any further ado, let's get right to the video. Wait. Before we jump into the video, take a moment to subscribe to my channel and to all my social media, which is linked down below in the description box without fail. If there's one thing that your skin absolutely hates, it's the harsh sun, and it's summer now. So you need to give your skin the maximum nourishment possible before you put on any makeup. So I'm starting off by using a serum. This serum is by Avène for sensitive skin. This has been suiting my skin really well. So I'm going in to taking a small pump of that, warming it up between my fingers, and I'm patting it into my skin. Once the serum has settled in, I'm going in with a moisturizer by Plum. This is the green tea moisturizer. And again, a teeny bit of that, rubbing it in between my fingers and warming it up. So this makes your products get absorbed into the skin really well. You don't want to keep swiping things in, because these are things that you do every day, and over a period of time, it's just going to start sagging your skin, and it's not good for your skin at all. And then I'm going in with this sunscreen by Plum. This is also a very nice sunscreen for sensitive skin, and I've been loving it lately, but it's a little thick, so you don't want to apply too much, otherwise you're going to get a white cast on your face. And make sure you always cover your neck. Never forget your neck area, because it's as sensitive and as important as your face. So we are done with the sunscreen, and my skin might be looking a little sticky, because it is sticky because we put so many cream products on the face. So we need to give it about 5 minutes to settle in before we apply the primer. Otherwise the primer is going to slip off and all the makeup is going to come off your face. All the products have settled into my skin. It feels slightly tacky, that is perfectly fine, but it shouldn't feel like extremely sticky in a way that whatever you put on your face is going to slip off. So now it means that your face is moisturized and the product has been absorbed into your skin, and that's exactly what you need. Next, we're going to go in with a primer. Today I'm using the LA Girl Pro and Prep Primer. This is a very nice primer for an everyday use, and it's a silicone-based primer. Silicone-based primer, we're using it on a daily basis, but this is going only into my T-zone, because I tend to sweat a lot in these areas, and all the foundation or concealer or whatever I apply tends to move away. As I said before, you never want to swipe the primer into your skin. You always want to pat it in. Now the primer has settled into the skin, I'm going in with a foundation. This is the Maybelline Fit Me in the shade 230. My skin is really dry, but I seem to be liking this foundation a lot. We're going to take the teeniest bit and apply it all over the face. We don't want a very full coverage for an everyday use. You don't want to look like, you know, you've got too much makeup all over your face, and you want it to look very natural, otherwise everyone's gonna keep looking at you in a very funny way, isn't it? So here is my beauty blender. I am just patting it into my skin. Now that we have the foundation thoroughly blended into the skin, we are going in slightly with a concealer to just conceal all the dark spots and any under eye circles that you have. I'm going in with the LA Girl Pro Conceal in the shade Natural. Again, we don't want to put too much of concealer, because it's going to end up looking like a clown. Very, very little. And of course, wherever you have dark spots, So now that I look like a clown, we're just going to blend in all the concealer into my skin. And whenever you apply a concealer, you don't want to move it from its place because we are using this to spot conceal. So now we're setting our face with a powder, and this is the Studio Fix by MAC. This has always been my favorite powder foundation. So we are going in under the eyes first. This we mainly do because you're going to have this makeup on for the whole day. You don't want your face to really crease and look weird. So as soon as you're done with blending your face, you better go in with a powder product and set everything in its place. Of course, no product is crease proof, but obviously we want to avoid creasing as much as possible. So now what we're going to do is give our face a very, very slight contour with a powder product. So we're going in with this powder contour by Makeup Revolution. I've lately been loving this palette because of the various, you know, shade ranges that's available in this. It could be for lighter skin tones, it could be for deeper skin tones. It works wonders and I'm really loving this. I'm going in with the lightest contour shade here today because we don't want it to be very, very harsh. I'm going along this line and giving it a slight shadow effect. And I'm going in to my jawline so that I get a defined jawline and we have no double chin going on. So next we're going in with this ombre blush by Wet n Wild. I chose this because I don't want the blush to be very overwhelming, and this has a very natural sheen to it. It's not a total matte blush, so I sort of seem to like this product a lot. I'm going in with this pink shade, only that, and I'm going into the apples of my cheek. You need to smile and just go to the apples of your cheek straight. So next we're going into highlighting the face. I'm using the same blush and I'm going in to this sandal kind of a color on top. I'm just going for that. This will serve to be a good highlight, I hope. So yes, we've got the highlighter on and I feel it's absolutely not enough. I'd like a little more highlighter because it looks very, very subtle. So I'm taking the same palette by Makeup Revolution, going in for this shade out here. I'm taking the slightest amount and yeah, this seems a lot better because it is still giving a very nice highlighted effect and it's not very, very shiny. It is very, very subtle. For the brow today, I'm going in with the Brow On Point Microfine Pencil by Nykaa. This is a very, very nice eyebrow pencil and I seem to be liking it a lot. This was one of the products in my haul this time that I bought in newly, and I really seem to be liking this product. We don't want to really, you know, go over the top with the brows because it's going to be a very natural finish. So once I'm done drawing the brows, I like to go in with this Oh My Brow Brow Mascara by Nykaa. This really sets everything in place and doesn't let your brow products to budge. So going in lightly, and this also fills in any spots that you have left out with the pencil. So this is going to be a very quick thing that you're going to do in the morning. So there you go. You can see the difference. Once I've applied that, it looks much fuller and more natural. So that's exactly what I want. So for my eyes, I'm going to take the same contour color that I use. This is what I use for my cheeks. And going in with a very fluffy brush, holding the tip of the brush because I don't want any precision. I'm going in to my whole eye. Maybe because I want to intensify a little more, I'm going in with a slightly darker brown shade out here. And very slightly touching the outer corner of my eye, just the outer corner. And that's it. I'm done with the eye. With the same white color here, I'm highlighting my brow bone. So next we'll move on to the mascara. I'm using the Chamber Infinite Lash Mascara. So this is the lengthening mascara. I'm going in with the mascara. How I like to apply the mascara is to go to the bottom and roll it upwards. So you want to go to the bottom, either you can wiggle or and also onto the bottom lash line. We are doing a makeup tutorial here in which you want your makeup to last for the whole day. So what I like to do, especially for the lip color to last for the whole day, is to first go in with the lip pencil. This is the lip pencil by MAC. It is in the shade Soar. I'm going in to lining my lips and filling my lips with the same color. So now I'm going into using the matte lipstick by Nika K in the shade Turkish Rose. This is one of my favorite colors for an everyday use. But the way it wears off is not really nice. It, you know, goes away in little bits from here and there. So this is a hack that I found. That is to use a lip liner and fill it in with the same lip liner before I use this lipstick. It wears off in a very beautiful way and the problem just gets solved. So as a final step, I'm going in with my makeup fixing spray in the matte finish by NYX . With that, we come to the end of this video. So if you like this video, don't forget to give it a thumbs up, subscribe to my channel and hit the bell icon so that you're notified whenever I upload a video. And keep supporting me, leave all your comments down below and subscribe to all my other social media, which is linked down below in the description box. I'll see you soon with another video. Bye-bye.